Is this thing on? How do these things work anyway? Oh, it is on. Perfect. Okay, here I go. Let's do this. People of Earth, I am Starscream of the Decepticon Army. You may also recognize me as the Ace of the Air or the Pride of the Cybertron Academy. For years, you have watched me as I've tried to usurp leadership from Megatron and failed. Well, except for those very, very brief moments like when I created the Combaticons or that time in 1986. But anyway, I have given myself a ranking that is worthy of my talents and skills and is far beyond that of Decepticon leader. From this day forward, my rank shall be known as Top Gun.
Hey, Starscream, what's with the geeky getup?
Yeah, Megatron's gonna blow a fuse if he sees you in that outfit again.
I don't care about Megatron. I outrank him now. I'm Top Gun. Years ago, the Flesh Creatures made a movie called Top Gun, and I was in it. I even have the human here who sings the Danger Zone song. See?
Hate to break it to you, Starscream, but I'm not Kenny Loggins.
What? But I always hear you saying Danger Zone.
Well, yeah, that's just kind of something that I do to annoy the people at my job. Say, have you got any more of this Energon? This stuff is good. I think I'm drunk already.
Whatever you say, Screamer.
Let's go get some good seats. I can't wait to see what happens when Megatron gets his hands on him this time.
Nah, no matter. Once the human movie reviewer gives my movie and my performance a great review, the Decepticons will surely follow me over Megatron. Let's tune him in.
Hey, Starscream! Oh, you're doing that thing again now, huh? With the cape and the crown?
Say, has anyone ever told you you look like you got that because you made a donation to the Save the Geeks Foundation?
Nice. You know Megatron's gonna kill you when he sees you in that getup again, right?
Why does everyone keep doubting me? I'm not threatened by Megatron. I'm the superior leader now.
Nah, it's your funeral. So, as the brain said from Pinky and the Brain, I feel the need. The need for expeditious velocity. Or, I feel the need. The need for speed. Quote from the original Top Gun movie. Let me say a few things before I get to the review. One, normally I tend not to watch sequels to original movies that are 30 years old or beyond 10 years old. Why? Because I think the perfect time for sequels for a movie should be within the 10-year time frame, because the audience tends to grow. If there isn't any sequels, the audience tends to grow and move on and lose interest, and the original movie tends to become what? A classic to those people who love the first movie. So when the audience moves on and loses interest, and then a sequel comes out, 9 times out of 10 they're going to compare it to the original, and a good chunk of the time the sequels aren't going to live up to the originals because so much time has passed and so many people have moved on. Especially the actors, directors, people have died, things like that happen. So, but I've made exceptions in the past, although I hate to a lot of the times. Made exceptions for the Star Wars sequels, for Ghostbusters Afterlife, and Space Jam A New Legacy, and a few other movies here and there. So, I wasn't going to go see this movie. I wasn't interested in it. I just thought that it wasn't, it was unnecessary. But word of mouth and my wife wanting to watch it, I thought, okay, let's see what the hubbub is all about, and I went to go watch it. Okay, so number two, I haven't watched the first Top Gun in ages. I watched it the first time it came out, and that was the summer of when I was going from the 7th to the 8th grade middle school. So as you can see, got the gray on my face, lack of hairline, and boobs. My eyes are up here. So, I don't remember very much about the first Top Gun. Not that it was a bad movie, and not that I didn't want to watch the movie. It's just that when I think of a movie that I want to rewatch, Top Gun isn't on my list. And also, another part of the problem was for me during that time as well, my obsession, my passion, and my possession, I guess you could say, as I call it now, was animated cartoons. So if it wasn't animated, if it wasn't Muppet related, if it wasn't comic book related, or even comedy driven, 9 times out of 10, I didn't watch it. So I only watched the first Top Gun maybe once or twice. So I may not remember everything. Things are going to be a little bit fuzzy. Good thing, though, the movie did kind of put bits and pieces here and there to, you know, remind you of certain events that happened in the first movie. So now that that's over, let's go on with the review and talk about the, have a plot summary, okay? Maverick is a test pilot for a new experimental aircraft that's being developed. Until, reluctantly and specifically, he gets a call from up top to return to the fighter's weapon school, aka Starscream.
Top Gun!
Gotta let him have as much screen time as possible. That ego of his is the size of Texas.
Shut up and get on with the review.
I'm just saying. So, Maverick is back, and he's teaching a group of young hotshot pilots for an impossible mission. See what I did there? And this mission, should they choose to accept it, is one that is very reminiscent of a certain movie franchise that takes place in a galaxy far, far away, fourth chapter to be precise. And since Maverick doesn't do things by the book,
bye-bye book,
well, it's up to Maverick to teach these kids and train them to get them prepared for this particular mission, this Mission Impossible, if you will. So, will his training work? Will they accomplish their mission? Will they all come back alive?
Find out in the next episode of Dragon Ball Z, Top Gun Maverick.
So, let's talk about the positives, okay? One, it's not a complicated story. Easy to follow. That's great. There are some connections here and there between the original and this movie, and that's fine too, to kind of help you remind you of what's happened, you know, what are the connections, and but the best part about it is that it's simple, it's fun, it's the right amount of everything, no complications, and it's all done right. The other thing is, does it hit on the nostalgia? Yes, but that's a good thing. And again, it's done right. This is Maverick's story first and foremost. He's not a supporting character. He's not someone that's overpowered or pushed aside for the new characters, all to make an unnecessary point of, you know, I'm a person of color, or I'm this gender. You're a relic. Get out of the way, you old person. No, this is a team movie, and everyone, despite their age, their race, their gender, they're in this together, and they all contribute in some form or fashion, basically, to accomplish this mission. So, you will become invested in it, as I do, and with a good chunk of movies, I usually don't become too invested in them, but in most movies, especially like this, where I kind of feel like, okay, I'm in the classroom, or I'm in on the plan, and I'm trying to figure things out as the characters are, and I'll talk to myself a little bit, not out loud, or talk to the screen a little bit, again, not out loud, but for instance, there was one part where they're in the classroom, and, you know, they're explaining the plan of the mission, and, you know, I go, wow, they're sitting ducks at that point, and shortly thereafter, one of the characters says, well, wait a minute, we're sitting ducks at that point, and, I mean, so it can become predictable, but for some it may, for some it's not. No big deal about that, okay? So, then there's the actors. let's talk about the actors. You got Tom Cruise, you got Jennifer Connelly, you have several characters who are coming back, and it's so great to see them. But at the same time, it's almost like these guys, these people haven't acted in these roles in almost 30 years or about 30 years now at this point. It's almost as if they didn't skip a beat. And it's very refreshing to see how like they slip right back into those characters. It seems like with no issues whatsoever. The new actors that come into this, they're great as well. Top-notch performances. There's one actor, it's like, wow, they did a good job casting that particular person as this particular character. It's like, it's amazing how they did that. So, let's talk about another positive. There are hardly any CG effects in this. There's hardly any green screens. They're not acting on a stage surrounded by green all around them. This movie definitely makes use of practical effects, meaning they use actual materials in order to make this movie happen. So they're on an actual aircraft. They're on an actual aircraft carrier. Sorry, they're actually flying actual jets as they did in the first one. And so everything is real. You get the feeling and the realism of being in these jets and how powerful they are and the things that they can do and the things that the pilots can do with them. That's an excellent bonus. I really wish movies would start going back to that sort of thing to a certain extent. I understand that CG can do a lot more and practical effects can only do so much, but it's great to see the use of practical effects now. So, the negatives. There are hardly really any negatives in this, and if there are, they're very, very small. If I had to pick a negative or point out a negative, I would probably say it's the love story. In all honesty, and that's not really a negative or a positive, it's just the fact that it didn't do anything to push the plot forward, and it didn't hinder the plot either. So if the love story was there, fine. If the love story wasn't there, the film would still end up being the same. It was great. So you could take it or leave it. Positive or negative, you decide, okay? So in conclusion, this movie is what a true sequel should be. And it's what we should all want. Again, despite the fact that it came out more than 10 years later, I can overlook that. This movie is awesome. Go see it once, go see it twice, go see it three times, the lady. The best way to probably put it is, it's like an old piece of clothing that you haven't worn in a long time, and you put it on and it still fits. Or it's that movie, that TV show, that video game, or that song you haven't watched, heard, or played in a very long time, and you pop it in and everything just comes back to you. Better example, it's that family member, that best friend that you haven't seen in years, and seen or talked to in years, and you see each other and talk to each other for the first time in all that time, and you pick up right back where you left off. It's as if no time has passed at all. That's what this movie is. Oh, and P.S. There's no beach volleyball scene in this, but there is a beach football scene in this. So you have half-naked, oiled-up people playing beach football, which, that's a positive for many of you if you like it. So that's about it. Again, go see this movie. Buy the Blu-ray, buy the DVD. Go support this movie. You won't regret it. Okay? So that's it. Hopefully that helps. Now, back to you, Starscream.
Excellent review, Flesh Creature. But what you failed to mention was my brilliance in this movie. How are the other Decepticons going to take me seriously now?
Well, yeah, you were in it for, like, the last, what, 20 to 25 minutes of the movie? But you were an old rundown relic. I mean, you played your part well, and you did pretty good, but in all honesty, it was the actors who sold it, not you.
What? How dare you insult Starscream the Mighty and Top Gun? I am no relic. I am in excellent condition. I am autotomic perfection.
Hey, I'm just being honest with you.
Call me a relic. I'm not a relic. Megatron's the relic. That's why we need a new leader of the Decepticons. Me. If only there was another way for me to win over the loyalty and devotion of the other Decepticons so that they'll follow me and not him. After all, I'm Top Gun. What?
Danger Zone.
I thought you said you didn't sing that song. Why are you singing it now?
Top Gun, eh, Starscream?
Megatron! It's not how it looks, Megatron. I was just trying to do a movie review for you and
shut up, you fool! I lead no matter what idiotic ranking you come up with. Human, prepare to receive your target, Starscream!
This is so cool! I get to wield Megatron as a gun!
The way I see it, Starscream, I'm the only gun that has the top rank! Wouldn't you agree?
Yes. Yes, Megatron.
Wait, Megatron. I got an idea. While you're like this, let's make him dance.
An excellent idea, human! Dance for our amusement, Starscream!
But I don't know how to dance!
And yet you have very poor taste in fashion.
I love this human! Now dance!
Do the moonwalk!
Is this right?
Do the monkey!
This is so embarrassing!
Now do the Cupid shuffle!
How did they do these dumb things, and why did they give them such dumb names? Hey, I think I'm getting the hang of this. This is kind of fun.
He's enjoying himself now. That's no fun. Party's over.
Leave my sight, Starscream, and take that goofy outfit off, as if you don't embarrass yourself enough already.
Just you wait, Megatron. You'll see. I'll find the pumpkin patch that is real sincere, and I'll sit in that pumpkin patch, and I'll see the great pumpkin. Wait, where did that come from? I'll get you next time, Gadget! Next time! I've got to stop watching so much Earth television. I'm starting to sound like that walking Autobot scrap heap Wreck-Gar.
Human, I like how you function. Let's go get some Energon. I'm paying.
Oh, that is so cool. Hey, let me call up a friend so he can join us. You'll love him, too.
Later.
So, anyway, I say, no more Optimus Prime! Grant me mercy, I beg of you! You know, pour it on a little bit so I can stall and get to the gun, right? So, anyway, he makes this long speech about mercy and sterner stuff, I don't know. But lucky for me, this Autobot shield shows up out of nowhere. So I use the shield, pick up the blaster, and blast Optimus Prime to pieces.
Oh, yeah. So cool.
Classic Megatron.
Hey, Megatron, what if I told you that there's a way to where you can get all of the Energon that you need, get the golden disc, collect all of the mini-cons, and get your hands on the AllSpark or whatever that thing is, and conquer Cybertron without the Autobots figuring it out until it's too late?
All you need is this right here.
Excellent.
Many months later.
It is the year 2022. With the help of Rick Sanchez and Sterling Archer, the treacherous Decepticons have once again conquered the Autobots' home planet of Cybertron.
Vector Sigma. That does it for this episode of No Spoilers. And remember, if it looks like dog poo, it must be spoiled. Tune in next time. I'm your announcer, Stan Lee, signing off. Excelsior!
Megatron's a fool, and he's no longer fit to lead. I've got the skills, the bravery, and the need for speed. I can lead us right into the Starscream Zone. That's right, I can lead us right into the Starscream Zone.
Starscream!
Meanwhile.
Hot Rod, report to me at once. Yes, Optimus?
I want you to make a special run to Japan.
But we're supposed to be taking back Cybertron. I want to help.
No! Crimzeek. Yeah, that's it. Crimzeek. Megatron has created another Crimzeek, and it's wreaking havoc across Japan.
And I want you to go take care of it. You can count on me, Optimus!
Oh, and take Wheelie with you for support.
But Wheelie wants to stay. Can help save the day.
You can help save the day by going with Hot Rod. Now, get going, you two. There's very little time left.
You're not gonna kill me off and replace me with him this time.
You hear that, Hasbro? Not this time.
Now that that's out of the way,
Autobots, let's head for Cybertron!
Not so fast, flesh creatures. Did you watch the movie that we reviewed? Did you agree or disagree with our view? Post a comment down in the comment section below. And be sure to hit the like button. More likes means more votes for me as the new leader of the Decepticons. Until next time, Earth germs.